It's the Morning Brew with friends. I've been riding this bicycle all around the studio all morning because we're talking about Ciclovia today. And we're talking about men's health. We got Dr. Wayne Kwong this morning on with us. We have folks from the Biopark. We have Miss World, New Mexico World, Ashley Mora back here. And we have folks from Ciclovia and a whole lot more, all on the Morning Brew with friends. I wish I could do the whole show on a bicycle. Just keep riding around the set all morning. It'd be a blast. It's fun. These are the bikes you can rent.
Really?
Yeah. It's, I forget exactly how much it is, but it's cheap.
Wow.
And you just put your credit card in, and then you hit
right
the button.
On the back, yeah.
Yeah. And then you can ride it all around, and then you just return it, and done.
Wow. I'm going to have to try that out sometime.
They're cool. All
bike.
Around downtown.
Yeah, that's really
It's a
nice.
Fast bike, too. I
is
like it?
It.
Yeah, it's great. It's great. Well, first things first this morning, we got headlines. They are brought to us by our friends at Tony and Guy Hairdressing Academy. And this is sad. Have you been following the news out of California?
A little bit,
with the
yes.
wildfires?
Mm-hmm. It's really
It is amazing. And the devastation is really sad in California right now. I guess this is the really what happens when you have a drought.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just like New Mexico several years ago, and we had our just ton of wildfires here.
Right.
And they're still out of control. Well, last night they were still out of control.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really sad. 1,000 people are now displaced from their homes. 1,000 and more than 1,000 buildings have been destroyed.
Oh.
270,000 acres.
Wow.
Which is, it's like unfathomable amounts of land when you start thinking 270,000 acres.
Right, that really is.
It's amazing. And then 8,800 firefighters are on the ground and they still can't control them. It's so dry though and so windy
mm-hmm.
that the embers are traveling at the speed of the wind and the firefighters can't catch up with it right
oh,
now.
Oh, wow.
So it's hard. We can't wait to see. Hopefully they get them contained today
yes.
and hopefully people can help out.
Yes.
And this is really interesting. Yesterday the governor announced her new energy policy for New Mexico. I didn't realize that we didn't have an energy policy.
I didn't really realize that either.
Right? It was one of those things. It was like, oh, a new energy plan. Well, what happened to the old one. It
right.
didn't exist,
right.
really. So I think it's cool that we finally have one. And it's
much
just,
needed.
Well, and, you know, it's kind of just one of those things where, like, it's everything. It's like our energy plan is just like we need all the energy we can get.
Right.
In New Mexico, we've been a state that really relies on oil and gas. But that's kind of energy that is bottled and then sent other places.
Mm-hmm.
It's not really energy that we get to keep. And so she's talking about things like coal-fired power plants, talking about this is really, you know, of course, renewables, wind and solar were great for that here in New Mexico, right?
Right, definitely.
And, but one of the real interesting things I thought about this was there's a thing that she's calling micro reactors.
Hmm.
I've got to research this. This
yes.
is like my job for the day is to figure out what a micro reactor is because apparently a micro reactor is a little tiny nuclear reactor that can produce electricity cleanly, cheaply. And of course, you know, everybody's going to say, well, it's nuclear.
Right.
But I don't know yet. I've never heard of a micro reactor. I don't know where they exist yet. And I don't. Maybe it's just like, if we had the $1 billion to put into something, we would build one of these. I'm not sure,
right.
but I can't wait to find
I'm
out.
I'm going to have to research that as well.
Right? But I think this is one of those plans, too, that I think with energy, everybody has their own, you know, pet thing that they want. You know,
right.
I love solar. I love wind.
Mm-hmm.
I think that all of that's great.
It's
I also know that you have to get coal to make it reliable,
mm-hmm.
you know, because it doesn't, there's no sun at night to power the solar panels, you
right.
know? So I don't know if an energy plan like this makes everybody happy or makes everybody mad.
I would think it would make most people happy, but I guess we'll have to find out.
Right, and we'll see how it goes. But
right.
I know that, you know, environmentalists are going to be mad about the coal stuff, and then, of course, the oil and gas industry
true.
Is not going to be happy about the wind and,
yes.
you know, solar. So we'll see what happens. But it's interesting. I just think it's great we finally got a plan. And this is one of those things. I love tennis. I like sports, and
right.
this is great. And one of the fun things I like to watch on TV is tennis. And Novak Djokovic beat Roger Federer. Look at all those people. This is,
wow.
it's huge. That's Arthur Ashe Stadium at Flushing Meadows in New York. And
that's a lot of people.
Right? It's one of my dream things is to go see, like, a world-class tennis match like this. I think it would be just a blast.
Mm-hmm.
And Roger Federer, you know, one of the greatest of American tennis players ever.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I didn't realize this. He's 34 already.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And,
I would never guess that.
Right. He looks great. He plays just unbelievably well.
Yes.
But when he's playing a 27-year-old Novak Djokovic, he just can't I think maybe it's age difference, but right. he did beat everybody going up straight sets, 28 straight sets.
Wow.
Up until the final, and then Djokovic just cut him off. And that was exactly what happened last year at Wimbledon, which was really sad. Mm-hmm. UNM has a new branding campaign. I think this is interesting. Spending $500,000 to basically spread the word about the University of New Mexico.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, which is great.
Interesting.
The school, outside of sports, mm-hmm. not really known.
Right.
You know, mm-hmm. so, and I don't know if our sports reputation, on the maybe on the football side especially, isn't the best. So they're trying to spend some money to let us know exactly, let the world know exactly what's up.
That's great.
And this week is the city's Umbrella Week. And this is the city's big chance to bring out all of the entrepreneurs. And I love these photos. We'll go through them pretty quickly here. The Ghost Food, this is like a... It's an art installation project, which is very cool. This is just some of the stuff going on. There's fashion stuff going on at the rail yards. And then last night I went to this cool thing. It was a virtual reality cafe. And they set up this giant dome. There's the TEDx folks. They kicked it off on Saturday. The virtual reality dome was cool because you walked in it and you can look around and see everything.
Wow.
Tonight there's the pitch contest at the stereo bar. And then finally... I love watching Celebrity Apprentice because it's just one of those shows where you get involved in it.
You
get
do.
Stuck in it.
And definitely.
So now that Donald Trump is running for president, mm-hmm. who's going to take it over? This guy. There he is. Arnold Schwarzenegger is now the new host
wow.
of Celebrity Apprentice.
Hmm. Interesting.
I don't know what that's going to be like. I don't know if he'll fire you or, you know, he was governor. Maybe he'll veto you.
Right, maybe.
That
we'll
would be,
see.
Yeah, you're vetoed. Oh.
It's going to be fun to watch.
I'll get to the chopper. And we'll see what happens. I'll be back. We'll be back in a couple of minutes on The Morning Brew with Friends. And we're going to be talking with the doc about men's health this month.